All week on our field goal block. We put Milton in there. We're just fortunate that he missed it. You know, it's a great football game, though. We're excited about the win.
The third down stop.
Yeah, I think it was huge. But the second down, you know, when we were able to back them up and get the stop and get the sack there, I think was real important. We knew they would take a shot in the end zone. We weren't sure whether it'd be a post from the one receiver side or a read route to the field. Coach Grantham did a great job. We had them both double and were able to make the play.
How big is it for this program, for these kids to get?
Yeah, I'm just real happy for our players. You know, we knew it was going to be a fourth quarter game, and they competed extremely hard. I thought our assistant coaches on offense did a great job on the sideline of calming our guys down, getting our poise. Felt like we got a little bit tight in the third quarter. Coach McGee did a great job of calming them down. Reggie did an unbelievable job there in the fourth quarter of leading us down. And, you know, we knew we felt like we could run the ball, and we did it late in the game, which is really important to win games.
What did Reggie Cliff ran hard?
Yeah, he runs really hard. He's fast, you know, and it was great to see. I thought Dyer gave us some real good runs. And then Reggie's ability to run the ball in the first half was huge for us, getting a couple balls in the end zone there. They made some adjustments, and that opened up some inside run.
How do you think Reggie held up in this kind of atmosphere? He made some huge plays for
him. Yeah, he's a pretty calm guy, you know, and I'm really proud of him. He's a great young man, and he's a great leader. Everybody's behind him. All his teammates are behind him. He kept his poise and just kept competing.
What's this win at Notre Dame?
I think it's great for us. You know, I think it helps us in recruiting and gets us to 8 wins so far, and, you know, I think it's a great win. It's a fun place to come and play, you know, and the city of Louisville came up here and supported us. What an unbelievable crowd. Something I felt like we would have, because when the schedule came out early, you know, I can't tell you how many people said, yeah, I already got my tickets. So it's pretty cool.
You mean there'd be a lot of people there, but this many? Did you think there'd be
I didn't know there'd be this many, but, you know, it was pretty awesome when we got off the bus to come in. It was almost like we were at home with our card march, you know. So what great support.
Did you hear them there in the third quarter where they were?
Yeah, they were pretty loud. They helped us a lot. There's no question about that.
Bobby, in terms of history, in terms of the program.
It wasn't false starts in that, but in the end, when you needed it, they
really took over. Yeah, you know, it's hard to execute on the road. You know, we always worry about getting the cadence, getting going. We certainly got hurt by it, you know, at points in the game. But again, they just kept competing, and we were able to convert some first and 15s into first downs that allowed us to go score. So it was a good job of keeping their poise.
How much did that Florida State loss, do you think, kind of feed into being able to kind of steady themselves in this game?
Yeah, you know, I'm not sure. You know, I think we just come out and compete hard, and, you know, it looked like it could be back to overtime, you know. Unfortunately, we missed a field goal there. We had a chance to go score, didn't get it in. You start thinking about it, but then our defense came up with some big plays. And I think that's what's fun to watch is when the pressure was on, how hard our guys competed.
Biggest growth you've seen on this team? In terms of you've had to rearrange a lot of pieces because your guys getting hurt?
Yeah, you know, they're fun to coach because they go out and work hard at practice. They've got a good attitude. They have a tremendous amount of energy. You know, I think the defense did a great job early in the year, understanding it's a team game. We didn't have any separation when the offense couldn't move the ball and, you know, couldn't get it in the end zone in a couple of games. So, I think it's proud of our defensive staff really making sure everyone understood that, hey, this is a team game. It's the offensive job to score one more point and the defense to stop them for less than 1 point. And they held together. I think that's what's really fun.
In your estimation, what's the difference between winning a game like this and losing it?
They missed a field goal and we made it.
You know, sometimes, I mean, is it that
it's just a, it's no, I, every play out there makes a difference. You know, every play out there makes a difference. And, you know, I think I'm just proud of our coaching staff and our players on keeping their poise and understanding that we got to just keep calling the game, keep making plays. And, you know, their quarterback's really good. You know, I watch him throw the ball. He can really make throws, and he can run it. And we did a good job, you know, putting pressure on him, sacking him sometimes. It really affected the game. It was a battle. You know, they're a very good football team. and we're proud that we came away with the win.
Bobby, you were part of the Orange Bowl. Was this bigger than the Orange Bowl? Was this, I mean, you were there for that?
I'm not real good on the biggest, you know, and that. I think that at the moment, this is a great win for us.
One game left and they didn't celebrate quite a bit. How do you make sure they don't get a little too high?
Yeah, we'll get ready for that game. That'll be fun.
How well do your defensive line play, specifically D'Angelo?
He's been playing really well for us. Does a good job on the run. He's learned how to rush the passer, which has really helped us here late in the year. Rankins is a great player. He doesn't, he's as good as there is with his technique and understanding what offenses are trying to do. He is a real calm guy out there that helps everybody get lined up. So he's a tremendous leader for us.
What made you go with Rankins with Brad Green back up there in the second half? Really a 9-yard halftime.
Just his speed. We wanted to try to get him in the secondary and get some long runs and utilize his speed. And, it's a good changeup. I was really happy with the way Dyer was running the ball in the first half. He made some great plays for us. And we just felt like, hey, let's give Brandon a chance and see if his speed shows up. And, our offensive front was feeling good about running the ball. And we made some really good runs to win the game.
Well, last question, guys. Last question.
You mentioned his speed. Kid doesn't go down, and he's not built like a bowling ball.
Yeah, he works hard. You see him work in practice, man. He goes hard every play in practice. He's really a lot of fun to coach, and he's really tough. So we just got to make sure he tucks the ball away and runs all the way to the back of the end zone.
Coach, how big of a game is this? How big of a win is this?
I mean, it's a good win for us. I'm really proud of our players. I'm really proud of our assistant coaches.
All right, guys, we got to roll.
Thank you very much.